You're watching Tag TV. You're watching Tag TV.
Hello viewers, I'm your host Uzma Jafri with another episode of South Asia Focus. Let's begin today's show with the growing pandemic of coronavirus in the subcontinent India. The largest and the most populous country in the region has taken a host of new measures, including a countrywide lockdown to contain the spread. The streets are deserted and the people are maintaining social distance at the limited accessible places.
Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi ordered a 21-day lockdown of the world's second most populous country and fifth largest economy in the line of a host of measures being taken by New Delhi in coordination with the state governments to contain coronavirus pandemic. The announcement came just 2 days after the voluntary curfew was observed by entire nation on his call. This decision, however, is entirely different in nature and legally asks people to stay inside their homes.
पूरे देश में आज रात 12 बजे से संपूर्ण देश में संपूर्ण लॉकडाउन होने जा रहा है। हिंदुस्तान को बचाने के लिए, हिंदुस्तान के हर नागरिक को बचाने के लिए, आपको बचाने के लिए, आपके परिवार को बचाने के लिए, आज रात 12 बजे से घरों से बाहर निकलने पर पूरी तरह पाबंदी लगाई जा रही है। अभी के हालात को देखते हुए देश में ये लॉकडाउन 21 दिन का होगा, 3 सप्ताह का होगा, तो कोरोना वायरस की संक्रमण साइकिल तोड़ने के लिए कम से कम 21 दिन का समय बहुत अहम है। अगर ये 21 दिन नहीं संभले तो देश और आपका परिवार 21 साल पीछे चला जाएगा।
Health researchers have warned that more than a million people in India could be infected with the coronavirus by mid-May, prompting the government to shut down all air and train travel, businesses and schools.
आज तो बहुत ही सुनसान पड़ा है, कुछ दिखाई नहीं दे रहा। तो मन भी बस काफ़ी ख़राब है, लोगों का कुछ काम करने के लिए है नहीं। पहले हलचल होती थी, यहाँ पे रस होता था काफ़ी, अब तो बिल्कुल सन्नाटा छाया हुआ है। आप भी देख रहे हो, इधर उधर कुछ भी नहीं दिखाई दे रहा है। तो बहुत बुरा लग रहा है कि हमारे देश में पूरे वर्ल्ड में ये है, तो काफ़ी ये बीमारी है और इससे ये हालात हुए हैं जिससे सब लोग परेशान हैं।
Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman announced a 1.7 trillion rupee or $23 billion economic stimulus plan, providing direct cash transfers and food security measures to give relief to millions of poor people hit by a nationwide lockdown over the coronavirus pandemic.
So the package that we come up with will benefit those migrant workers, those poor, those urban and rural poor, and the women. And this Prime Minister Garib Kalyan scheme that we want to come out with is expected to meet a total of 1,70,000 crores.
The government aims to distribute 5 kilograms of staple food grains, wheat or rice for each person free of cost, with a kilogram of pulses for every low-income family, helping to feed about 800 million poor people over the next 3 months. The The government also outlined plans for medical insurance cover of 5 million rupees or $66,000 for every frontline health worker, from doctors, nurses and paramedics to those involved in sanitary services.
We shall be providing 50 lakhs per person as medical insurance cover. For those warriors, the sanitation workers in government hospitals, the ASHA workers, and all of them, paramedics, nurses, all of them, doctors inclusive, will be given 50 lakhs per person for as medical insurance cover in case they need it.
A number of Indians across different cities of the country were seen maintaining social distancing, an appeal made by Prime Minister and a fundamental requirement to curb the menace of COVID-19. As per the statement released by Indian Health Ministry, the country is suffering due to the virus but has been relatively successful in flattening the curve. There have been around 700 infections so far. Police have enforced the lockdown strictly. However, the essential services, including the print and electronic media and food delivery, would be maintained.
Moving on to other parts of the region where the governments and the citizens have been putting in efforts to contain the pandemic. While a disinfectant drive was seen in the war-torn Afghanistan, the government of island nation of Sri Lanka has mobilized agencies and companies to home deliver the essentials. The country has also imposed a lockdown in several parts. Experts say that most of the countries in South Asia are ill-equipped to handle the pandemic, which might rise to catastrophic proportions in coming days. Hence, precaution is the only and the best way to deal with it. A report.
The city of Herat in Afghanistan sent workers to the street to disinfect vehicles and areas from the potential presence of the coronavirus. Dressing in white disinfection suits, workers sprayed cars and motorcycles passing by on street. They also educated and cautioned people along their course of disinfecting the town. Private beverage giant Coca-Cola has supported the drive in the town, which has recently seen a spike in the number of coronavirus cases.
Khatra Jilaguri az marad corona ma dar jadaha baramadim va amkari az mardam muhtaram mekhayam ke be khatir corona ra jaddi bigaran ke corona ma ra jaddi na gira.
The country has around 100 cases with one dead. There are fears its vulnerable health system, devastated by years of war, would be overwhelmed by an outbreak.
مرض کرونا اگه ادامه بگیره بسیار یک فاجعه انسانی به ولایت هرات رخ میده باید دولت به بزی چیز اقدام جدی بگیره مردم بیچاره از این چیز هم نداره اقتصاد مردم ولایت هرات هم ضعیفه مردم افغانستان فقیره بیچاره ای.
Afghanistan's health system has also had to deal with overcrowding at facilities that have struggled to treat the increasing number of civilians affected by the ongoing war. Currently, there is only one hospital in the capital that can properly diagnose patients with the coronavirus. The hospital located in West Kabul can treat 150 patients at a time.
مردم باید نکات سیر مرحات کنند از ماسک استفاده کنند دستکش بپوشند دستا خود زود بشنند و خیلی تجمع نکنند.
In Sri Lanka, state agencies and private sector companies have mobilized to deliver essential food and medicines to residents in the highly populated western province amid an indefinite lockdown to combat the spread of coronavirus. The effort was wide-ranging, including Buddhist priests, motorcycle delivery drivers, a bakery and pharmacy, although pharmacies are being kept open during a 24-hour curfew. The three districts of province, which include the capital Colombo, have been identified as hotspots for the virus. The curfew affects 5.8 million of the 22 million people who live on the island. Sri Lanka has had over 100 confirmed cases of the virus.
Bangladesh and Nepal too are adopting strict measures to control the rapid spread. Dhaka was forced to cancel all programs of its Independence Day due to the rising problems. Further, the two countries have used their security forces to contain the spread. Bangladesh's armed forces have been deployed to assist the administration in every divisional and district town to ensure that people maintain social distance and are taking precautionary measures.
The government of Bangladesh cancelled all activities on its Independence Day as fears of coronavirus spread gripped the capital city of Dhaka. Streets were visibly empty while continuous announcements were broadcasted over speakers telling people to stay in their homes on this public holiday. Military personnel have also been activated to patrol the streets amid disinfection activities being carried out as the country fights to contain the COVID-19 virus, with around 50 infected cases and 5 deaths being recorded to date.
আমরা রিকশা চালাই কিন্তু মানুষ থাক আর না থাক কারণ আমরা রোড বাড়ি তো আমরা টেকার দরকার যাও তো আমরা টেকা নিয়ে বাজার করি কিন্তু এখন তো লোকজন নাই আমরা খেপ মারতে পারতাছি না
The drive and measure, however, were of no use as several worshippers gathered at a central mosque in Bangladesh's capital of Dhaka for Friday prayers on March 27 despite a nationwide lockdown. The fight in such circumstances has become even harder for people and authorities in Bangladesh.
তো তুলনামূলকভাবে অন্যান্য সপ্তাহ থেকে আজকে অনেক মুসল্লি কম করোনা ভাইরাসের কারণে তো হয়তোবা সবাই সবার ঘরে পবিত্র জুমার নামাজ না পড়লো হয়তোবা জোহরের নামাজ আদায় করতেছেন এবং সবাই আল্লাহ পাক রব্বুল আলামিনের কাছে এই এই ক্ষতিকারক ইয়া হতে মুক্তির জন্য সবাই
Meanwhile, a week-long countrywide lockdown was announced as a precautionary measure against coronavirus by Himalayan nation of Nepal. Shopping malls and markets downed their shutters after the government announcement. Nepal, which will be under lockdown till 31st March, has so far reported only 3 cases of coronavirus out of 610 people tested.
नेपाल सरकारले आज बिहान 6 बजेबाट लकडाउन गर्ने भन्ने निर्णय गरेर सूचना सार्वजनिक गरी सर्कुलर भए अनुसार हामी चोकचोकमा खटिएका छौँ र बाटोमा गुड्ने राजमार्गमा गुड्ने सवारी साधन लगायत पैदल हिँड्ने यात्रुहरूलाई समेत हामीले यो स्वास्थ्यको लागि हो कसैलाई जनतालाई दुःख दिन खोजेको होइन तपाईँ हाम्रो स्वास्थ्यको लागि हो लकडाउन गऱ्यो भने एक मान्छे र अर्को मान्छेको बिचको दूरी टाढा बनाउन सक्यो भने यो सङ्क्रमण रोग फैलिँदैन
Nepal has also closed all of its Himalayan peaks, including Mount Everest, this climbing season because of the fears of the coronavirus outbreak. Nepal, home to 8 of the world's 14 highest mountains, including Mount Everest, earns about $4.4 million a year in permit fees from climbers, aiming to scale the world's highest peak and other mountains.
While the entire world is exploring new ways and means to fight and defeat the deadly coronavirus, a satanic Pakistani design has emerged amid this global crisis. The infected patients from Pakistan's favored province of Punjab are being shifted to the occupied region of POK, posing a major threat to people of the region, which has a crumbling health infrastructure. People and activists fear that the move might trigger a local outbreak and hundreds of thousands might die. A report.
People in the Mirpur district of the illegally occupied POK have taken to the streets against Pakistan establishment following its decision to transfer the coronavirus patients to the region. They are demanding an urgent rollback of the decision, which will allow some 200 infected patients to come and quarantine in the privately owned Mohyuddin Islamic Medical College in the district. People say there are no facilities in the regional hospitals to fight the deadly virus, and the shifting has diabolic agenda.
हम मीरपुर में दूसरे जिला के लोग मरीज नहीं आने देंगे हमारा ये मुतालबा है कि मुजफ्फराबाद में जाए रावलाकोट में जाए जहां पर इनका इंतजाम किया मीरपुर में कोई इंतजाम नहीं है हम मीरपुर के लोग
देखिए मोहल्ले में जिस जिले के लोग उधर होने चाहिए उधर ही जाए
While 71 patients have already been brought to the hospital, another batch of 100 more patients is in the line. Only one patient has been found infected with the coronavirus in the region, and people fear that the arrival of more patients will trigger a catastrophe. POK activists living in exile have condemned the government's decision and have called its handling of situation a failure. They believe that Pakistan has a hidden agenda behind sending patients to an ill-equipped region.
अब ये कोरोना जिसको दुनिया के एडवांस ममालिक टैकल नहीं कर सक कर रहे पा रहे उनके पास अभी तक ऐसा कोई मैकेनिज्म नहीं है अभी तक वैक्सीन नहीं आई तो हमारे लोगों को और आबादी के बीच में जाके ये पंजाब से लोगों को ला के तो वहाँ पे मीरपुर में ला रहे हैं और हमारे लोकल लोग ऐसे नाइव हैं कहते हैं जी इंसानियत इंसानियत नो डाउट कि हम इंसानियत पे बिलीव करते हैं हम हर इंसान के दुख में बराबर के शरीक हैं लेकिन आपके पास वो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर होना चाहिए वो मैकेनिज्म होना चाहिए जिससे आप किसी इंसान के लिए कोई उसको फ़ायदा पहुंचा सकें उसकी कोई ट्रीटमेंट कर सकें जो हमारे पास नहीं है तो इसीलिए जब हमने ये चीज़ आवाज़ इसके खिलाफ रेज की लोकल लोगों ने वहाँ पर प्रोटेस्ट किए तो इसको दबाने की कोशिश की गई
अमजद अयूब मिर्ज़ा हैज इवन अर्ज्ड इंडियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी to intervene in the issue and save the occupied region from the looming health disaster. He warns Indian government to open borders along Ladakh and Jammu to send masks and medicines for the people of the region.
ये पंजाब से पेशेंट्स जो है उनको वहाँ लेकर आ रहे हैं ये खबरें आ रही हैं और लोगों ने वहाँ प्रोटेस्ट किया है यानी एक तरफ हम कहते हैं लोग गैदर ना हों लेकिन दूसरी तरफ अब ऐसे स्टेप्स उठा रही है पाकिस्तान की गवर्नमेंट कि लोग प्रोसेशंस निकाल रहे हैं डेमोंस्ट्रेशन कर रहे हैं जहां लोगों की कॉन्ग्रीगेशन हो रही है तो इमरान खान जो है वो मुसलसल ये कह रहे हैं कि हमने क्वारंटीन नहीं करना अपना ये नहीं लॉकडाउन नहीं करना लॉकडाउन नहीं करना तो इसका क्या मतलब इसका मतलब यह पाकिस्तान की स्टेट फेल हो गई है मेरी अपील है प्राइम मिनिस्टर मोदी साहब से और इंडियन गवर्नमेंट से कि कम अज़ कम हमें गिलगित बल्तिस्तान से जो हमारा कारगिल का रास्ता है इसके रास्ते को खोला जाए इंडिया की मेडिकल टीमें भेजी जाएं गिलगित बल्तिस्तान इसी तरह जम्मू से हमारा रास्ता खोला जाए और वहाँ से हमारे जो मेडिकल टीम्स हैं इंडिया से उनको भेजा जाए हमें इस वक्त वेंटिलेटर्स चाहिए सैनिटाइजर्स चाहिए मास्क चाहिए पैरामेडिक्स चाहिए डॉक्टर्स चाहिए तो प्लीज़ इस वक्त जो है हम मुश्किल में हैं और हम ऑक्यूपाइड टेरिटरी में रह रहे हैं तो हमें इस वक्त भारत की सरकार जो है वो खुसूसी तौर पर यूनाइटेड नेशन से या पाकिस्तानी गवर्नमेंट से जिस तरह भी हो सकता है नेगोशिएट करके ये बॉर्डर खोल के हमारी जानें बचाए
While Pakistan has been systematically violating the human rights of people of occupied regions for the past 7 decades, this act has truly exposed their barbaric and inhuman designs. While the country itself has failed in containing the spread, its evil system cannot digest the fact that people in the region of POK are healthy.
India is well known around the world for its vibrant culture and its colorful way of life. Recently, Indian state of Tripura organized tribal cultural festival. The festival witnessed food lovers from across the state. Have a look.
It's
Tripura is the land of festivals. Be it a tribal festival or non-tribal festival, almost all the festivals in Tripura are celebrated with great vigor and enthusiasm by all the tribes. To promote tribal art and culture, preservation of the tribal heritage of Tripura, a four-day-long cultural festival was recently held at Vivekanand Stadium in Agartala. Organized by the Tribal Research and Cultural Institute of the Government of Tripura, the festival was inaugurated by Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb. Tripura's cultural diversity is reflected in the food habits of the tribal and non-tribal people. The main attraction of the festival was the ethnic food stall. These delicious traditional food items are mostly boiled food, oil-free, and most of them are cooked with herbs. Leaving aside the rich spicy food, these traditional foods are not just delicious but healthy too.
Tribal food is very rich. It is very purely this original, and it's very, very less we get the oil here, and it is purely without oil, and this is all, most of the item is boiled.
Popular Tripura cuisines including Vahan Moose Teng, Mui Burok, food cooked in the bamboo stem, sticky rice, fish curry, and other authentic Tripura cuisine were some of the lip-smacking delicacies that were served at the festival. Visitors, young and old, were seen enjoying the traditional home-cooked delicacies.
I am so proud of my own state culture. यहाँ पे आप देखो, यहाँ पे कोई फास्ट फूड नहीं है. ये हमारा स्टेट का जो एथनिक जो फूड है, जो ट्रेडिशनल जो फूड है, उसका फेस्ट है. पूरा का पूरा एथनिक फूड का फेस्ट है. और दैट इज फुल्ली मेड अप ऑफ द इंग्रेडिएंट्स दैट इज फाउंड इन हिल्स एंड द वैलीज ऑफ आवर स्टेट. एंड यू कैन गेट द फ्लेवर ऑफ आवर स्टेट हियर. सो मुझे यहाँ पे आकर बहुत बहुत अच्छा लगा.
Various cultural activities, fashion shows and cultural folk songs were presented at the festival. The festival also provided a platform for the scheduled tribe communities to showcase their talent.
Several such festivals with state or regional themes are celebrated across the country around the year. With that, we come to the end of this week's episode. See you next week. Goodbye and take care.